Welcome back to Let's Play Enderal. Forgotten Stories. Blind. I messed around with this off-screen. The heath in the west is called the Sun Coast. It's regarded as peaceful and fruitful or plentiful and stuff like that. Is this the... Is this the marketplace? Yes. Yeah. As you see, this is a little ridiculous. More than a little ridiculous. They're attacking him. Jespar. And I can't talk to him. I am using the action button and I cannot talk to him. They're attacking him because... I pickpocketed the guy. Usually stands over here, and they were going after me as well. But then I crouched, and once they no longer saw me, they kind of forgot all about me, and they don't care anymore. They just want to kill him, but somehow he's completely invulnerable, and I wanted to continue with this quest. Off screen, I figured out how to do this. Hopefully it works again. He's like, get me the hell away from these people.
Oi, aren't you? Stay where you are.
Move along.
He's running?
Hello.
Hey. I know you. I don't know who you think you are, but no one breaks the law and gets away with it.
Took you a while.
There are two ways we can do this. You either pay your fine now, or you go straight to jail. And believe me, I'm serious.
Straight to jail. Okay, I'll pay.
Fine. But believe me, next time, you won't get off so easily.
Oh, don't take me away. Felt something biting me. Oops. Is it this way? Yes. This way and hang a left. Okay, is this foolishness done now? Plus,
I
watched back the video. And I don't know why I don't see these things. Shut up. I don't know why I don't see these things when I'm recording, but I spotted it on the way back. The thing that Gulfer stole or took or something like that. From that one guy, I forget his name. We have a quest for it. It's in his inventory. I can buy it from him. I can't pickpocket it from him. But
yes.
I can buy it, yes.
Uh-huh.
So just remind myself and you guys, who are we looking for? The Soul Place. The locksmith Meogre Ironford seems to be burdened with something. While talking to him, he mentioned that a certain golfer has proven that money is all that counts for him in the end. Perhaps I should investigate what this monger did. Now I was confused because you don't even know what he did. Search his assortment of goods for things which could belong to Meogre Ironford. I didn't realize you buy something from him. I started actually looking through his goods. So, Ironford.
We always go too easy on this guy.
I beg your pardon. So everything is fine. We can talk to Jespar after this.
Just put them out for you to look at.
Yeah.
Tell me what you need and be quick about it.
Ironford's loot, right here. Bring the loot to Meogre.
Walk.
He's not a very nice guy, is he? So that's the loot. Not really do anything with it, but ta-da! He's in the barrack quarter? Is he really in the barrack quarter? Thought he was in the, foreign quarter.
Hungry for arcane secrets?
Walk blessed.
Let me just check from here. I slammed the door into her. Because it might be telling me to go through the foreign quarter to get to him. No, he says he's in the barrack quarter. So just run from here. Let me just turn the other thing off. And then we'll go back to Jespar. After I've completed at least some of this and given him that thing back.
Huh? Help you?
Been a while since we
yes?
completed a quest or advanced a quest.
Is it important?
To Ironford it is. People
greetings.
Are very sleepy.
My dame.
My time.
So maybe this guy just wanders around and he's in the barracks quarter right now. Or maybe he went to jail. I got it. Apparently he's right over there. Oh, I didn't see it. Oh, he's at the Temple of Malphus for some reason? Alright. Maybe he's praying for his stuff back.
But that's how it is.
That's how it is? Hey, hey!
Hmm?
Ta-da! Any chance this has to do with your anger?
That? By Malphus, where did you get that? You didn't buy it from that cutthroat, did you?
I
please,
did.
Let me see it. I need to know it's real.
How would I know this, though? How would I know that it's his? Kind of makes no sense. It makes more sense to open a dialogue and say, you know, start hinting around about Mal Ironford, and then the guy lets slip that he took his loot, and then we know it's his loot, you know, because... I mean, maybe you can explain it away that on the loot it says Ironford or something engraved on it, and I'm like, I'll just part with 81 coins, or whatever. Only if you tell me what this is all about in return.
Aye, of course. By the name of the sun, yes, that's hers.
You didn't tell me yet.
Vera was right.
Oh, Vera.
I have to remember that.
I don't know why you're doing this, but thank you. This really means a lot.
You're welcome. Who is Bella? Your companion? And who's Vera?
What? No, Bella. She was my daughter. She left us one moon's turn and a day ago now.
Oh, I'm sorry. I'm sorry to hear that. What happened to her?
Flesh maggots. She...
Oh my god.
A week before we found out, she had met this young man, you know? Oh, you should have seen her. There was so much life in her, so much joy. And then, all of a sudden... No, it just isn't fair.
My condolences. For what it's worth, I've lost a good friend as well. Not too long ago. Am I talking the guy I was traveling with stowed away on the ship? I guess so.
You did. I'm sorry to hear that. She was a poet, you know? She could play the lute and sing like no other. And she even taught herself how to write. Vera, my companion, and I, we thought she would one day travel through the lands and become a bard.
She's a poet, you know it?
What am I saying? I'm sure you have better things to do than listen to me grieving. But in case you want to know how her lute ended up in that bastard's hands, we had debts. And only 3 weeks after Bella left us, a Duneville caravan that carried a year's load of iron for us got robbed. But of course, neither that nor our loss made any difference to that cutthroat golfer, and he threatened to get me thrown into jail if I wouldn't pay by the first day of Star Summer Night. Well, I suppose you can connect the dots for yourself. The loot was precious, and we didn't have a choice. But still, it felt like selling a part of her. And until now, we had nothing left of her, save for the casket.
You can keep the loot, if you want to. It's a present.
Yes, that's very generous of you, really. Thank you.
You're welcome. What casket?
Her treasure chest, that's what she called it. She kept her songs and poems in there, and she would never show anything to anyone unless she considered it perfect. You know how poets are. And now she's gone, and only she knows how to open the casket.
Oh, I thought it was her burial casket you were talking about. But you're a locksmith, aren't you? You should know how to get it open, too.
I should. But the casket was a present I made for her myself, and I made the lock special. It's a complicated mechanism, but, simply put, there are four bolts that need to be pushed in a certain order, and only then will it open. Of course, I could smash it, but who knows what would happen to her things. If I somehow destroyed them, I would never forgive myself.
Sounds like you need a torch. Or a chainsaw, some stuff that you don't have in this world. Well, that inscription, that carving on the back of the loot. Alright, that doesn't make sense, and it says Ironford or something. That has something to do with how to open the casket, right?
Yes, left, right, left, down. But that's not all. The bolts have to be pushed 12 times.
Oh, brother. So we're missing 8 hints. Do you know if your daughter left more clues about them somewhere else?
Aye, I'm quite sure she did. Vera and I have ideas as to where, but at the moment I can't afford to spend a single day without work. Look, you were very generous to me. I know it's a lot to ask for, but do you think you could help us find the other hints?
Yeah, it still comes down to this. It's a lot to go through. And I've gone through enough already, even though it was a misguided attempt, so... yeah, that depends. What's in it for me?
I don't know.
True.
We hardly have anything left, so I cannot pay you.
I feel bad
but
now.
Maybe I could share my knowledge as a craftsman with you.
Oh, yeah.
And the Lord would surely bless you for your generosity.
Alright, I'll see what I can do.
Ah, thank you. I'm not asking this lightly, but you seem like a good fellow, and that is rare these days.
Not a fellow.
Bella loved this book of poetry, The Red Ballads.
Hmm.
And there was one particular edition she always rented from the Ark Library.
Oh, the library, good.
I hardly have any coin left to borrow it, but I'm almost sure she left a hint there.
That's excellent, because I'm pretty sure the library, yeah, we've been to all the other quarters, so the library's got to be in the Noble's Quarter, so we're going to be in that area. So, what about the last one?
Aye, there was a place Bella always visited when she had spare time. She worked on her poems there, I think. It's not far from the harbor. Do you have a map? There. If she left another clue, it must have been there. Thank you. I mean it. I will pray for you.
Why, thank you.
Hmm?
Search the library for information about moonshine ballads. Examine the cave in the King's Bay. It's a little bit of a more difficult... It's got 2 stars difficulty. I gotta start doing these quests. What we are going to do... Get back to this one. Jespar. Hopefully when I return, he won't have people swarming over him. Futilely trying to kill him again. Futilely? Futilely? I was thinking it's futilely trying to kill him again. The requirements for the Order's novices are high. Before they can advance to the rank of Keeper, they must first undergo a trial. And stuff. Alright, let's go talk to him.
My dam.
It's like 5 days later. Oh, hey.
Whoa. Look who's arrived. Did you have any problems finding your way around? The city can be quite a maze if you don't know it.
I kind of got lost on purpose. Not really. I'm used to big cities, I guess.
Right. You're from Ostia. I almost forgot.
We like
them. Quite fascinating, these places, aren't they? You can climb high, and you can fall just as deep. And every place vibrates with life.
True. Oh,
shit. I have to remember that.
That's true. Likes that too.
Here, put this on. And before you ask, yes, it's necessary. Just trust me.
I'm equipping Killian Guard and hat and fine. So he likes cities. Oh my god, what? Okay, it's not that bad except for the hat. That's ridiculous. I'm not keeping this hat on. Sorry.
My damn.
Yes.
A foreigner, huh? What a surprise.
What a surprise. I looked at the hat and I was surprised. There's still that thing there. Like, I wonder how I get what it is. Not gonna get to that. Anyway, yeah, on our way. Oh, he's running. Before she changes her mind. So I was wandering off again.
Move along.
Hey. I'll slap you. Mages who are not part of the Order, but are also wild mages. Traveling arcanists. And buy tomes. So, this is the nobles. Right, we did peek in here. Old waterworks. Alright, that's this place. Oh, they have a sign for marketplace.
Hello.
Why, hello.
Hello.
Hello. He's like, come on.
I'm so hungry.
Walk west.
Fit-size puzzle box. I'm gonna just go with him for now and we'll explore this place later. I've left him waiting long enough. Noble's quarter.
Usually those gifted with magic have to report their talent to the Order, and then pass a ritual that teaches them how to deal with their magic.
A ritual?
The journey to the water is what they call it. Once they've passed
this
that,
water?
The fever reduces to an endurable level, and
ducks.
New arcanists have their names registered in some kind of holy book.
Hmm.
But there are other ways to get rid of the fever, and I hope my employer can tell you about it.
Your employer? You probably told me about that, like, 40 episodes ago. I just completely forgot you had this employer.
Okay, almost there.
Oh, we're going into the barrack quarter. That's a surprise. What a surprise! Back in the barrack quarter, such a surprise. Is this someplace we can't get otherwise? Because I've been to the temples of mages. Are we going here to the Temple of Malphus? I thought we were going to the Sun Temple. Or is it one and the same? I'm coming. Again, this doesn't look familiar. Name is your sacrament.
And I mark, I will honor in life.
Well, we got a scroll for teleport to Ark. I can take that freely. Military barracks. Just knocking stuff around. Is this?
Yes.
Keeper?
Is this important?
I don't know. You tell me. Is this another keeper?
This is Holy Ground, Outlander. You do not belong here.
I'm with him. Tell him I'm with you. Sun Temple. Okay, awesome.
Hold it, my sir. No civilians beyond this point without explicit permission.
Yeah, we're in... Okay. We're in the barracks... quarter, but we're in an area... that we couldn't... You know what? That makes me wonder if I go to... Other quarters from, like, other places... if I can get to otherwise inaccessible places. You know what I'm saying? Because we came in through here, and I guess this is... I've explored this, but this is blocked off to me. Or maybe I just didn't see the way, either one. Because I've already been wondering, you know, if I go outside, you know, to the Heartland, if I go outside from the barracks, I'm going to be in a different area.
Who are you, and what leads you to this holy place?
He did.
I'm Jaspar Delvera, and I work for the Naramese
this
mages.
This is Holy Grand,
Outlander. Oh, right. The mercenary.
You do not belong here.
And who's your companion?
Marija de Luna from Ostia. Esteemed holder of de Luna's Empire of Tender Fragrance, the most prestigious perfumery in all of Vin. Archmagister Marigil sent for. Didn't he tell you?
The Archmagister. Well, that does sound like him. Fair enough, he may pass. But show this place the respect it deserves, mercenary. You too, my Dame de Luna.
This is
heard my word, fair lady.
Thank you. You do not belong here.
People aren't throwing arrows at us, are they?
You may pass, but treat this with respect, Outlander.
Is it? Oh, they're shooting arrows at these things.
Have you heard it? Apparently the Blue Islands Coalition sent an emissary here to Rendwell, despite the wars. They are bold. You've got to give them that.
I do not know who they are.
Magistrar Yeager approves your request. We will take care of
it. Hope he knows what he's doing. Who are you?
I have no idea.
May his light guide you.
I have to stop on my account. Just a second, just far. Oh! Okay, maybe a few seconds. Oh wait, I'm stealing. Oh no, sorry, I'm sorry. No, wait! I thought... I didn't realize that was a steal. I'm picking it from the ground. I'm sorry, guys. Now, this is not a steal. So why is that a steal? To pick the flower. I realized when I took the second one, it said steal. See, that's harvest. That's not stealing. Weird. That's not stealing. That's not stealing. Alright. Note to self, don't pick flowers.
This is Hope and Outlander.
This is Hope. Outlander.
Hold it, my sir. No civilians beyond this point without explicit permission. Who are you, and what leads you to this holy place?
Business. I'm Jaspar Delvera, and I work for the Naramese mages.
Oh, right. The mercenary. And who's your companion?
Marija de Luna from Ostian. Esteemed
Marija
de Luna's Empire
Luna.
Of Tender Fragrance, the most prestigious perfumery in all of Vin.
Yeah, totally.
Archmagister Marigil said...
Completely, who I have.
Didn't he tell you?
The Archmagister. Well, that does sound like him. Fair enough, you may pass. But show this place the respect it deserves, Miss Mary. You too, my Dame de Luna.
You have my word, fair lady. Thank you.
I won't pick any flowers, I promise. The Sun Temple. Patronage of Landlord Boric. Oh, it's an outside temple. That makes sense, Sun Temple.
Well, that went better than expected.
I was going to pick those flowers over there. Marijo de Luna's Empire of Tender Fragrance?
Hey, it worked, didn't it? That's all that matters. Nobody will suspect someone who's already in the temple. Anyway, I think it's about time I tell you a little bit more about this employer of mine.
Is that a real person?
His name is Constantine Firespark, and he's one of Narathzal Orenthiel's former followers.
Cool name.
Which the new Grand Master, Tialor Orenthiel, brought here by ship about 2 years ago. That means he's one of the former arch-enemies of the Order.
Hmm.
They usually wear green, while the Order wears white or red. That should make it easy for you to tell them apart. Firespark's pretty much the eldest of Narathzal's mages, and quite well-versed in magic, at least from what I've heard. Plus, he's a very gentle and likable fellow, which is why even the Keepers like having him around. Let's hope he can tell us a thing or two about these visions, and help you get rid of the fever. Come, follow me. Huh?
Follow me, huh? I look forward to looking around this place in a bit. And after we're done with this Chronicum? What this is? Novice Elia. Books! Oh my god.
Blazes, I just can't bloody believe it.
Do you speak? So that's a vow of silence or something. A pot of an ancient nation. Oh. I know I said I was going to follow him. Let me just...
What?
Hi.
What?
What? I'm not even going to look because they're going to see me. This one's taking a vow of silence as well. Chronicum Archive. Cool, though. Legem. Okay. Let's see if they don't talk. They don't speak.
What?
They say what, though? Don't you know light bulbs haven't been invented yet?
Alright, here we are. Hang on.
No. That's not how you do it.
Blast it! I'm just being careful.
We do. Give me that thing, now!
Ooh! That wasn't me.
Blasted, blistering blazes! That's what you get for working
killed
with
spoon?
I told you,
Master Firespark.
What? Now who the heck are you? Can't an old man have a moment to himself?
Absolutely not.
You hired me, the Magister, don't you remember?
Oh, right. Joseph the Scrounger.
Joseph.
So, why are you here? Had any luck?
Just spar. And yeah, we did find something. I
suggest you first of all tell me when I allowed you to drag your flings up here. Do you need me to explain the meaning of the words highly and confidential to you?
Flings.
I'm sure there's a lot you can explain to me, but let's save that for later. This particular lady over here needs your help, to be frank. Arcane fever.
Is that so? And what exactly has that got to do with me? Let the Keepers and their holy rituals take care of it. What is it with the costume, anyway?
This woman's magic is different, Meiser. Just feel her aura, and you'll see it. Plus, she's from Naren, just as you are.
That's right.
Well, all right then, for nostalgia's sake. I really hope you're not wasting my time, though. Working with these religious buffoons is bound to make any rational-thinking person go bonkers. Anyway, that chair over there. Take a seat, and I'll have a look at that fever of yours. All right, then. This will tickle a little.
Tickle? Ah!
You're right. This aura does feel different, complex somehow, and Powerful.
Well, now I feel different.
And do you really want to tell me you've only recently discovered that talent of yours? With that aura, I'm surprised that you haven't turned into an Obaya by now.
I don't want that to happen.
Fine, well, that is, we will help you. But first, tell me everything. How you got that magic, and how you met that scrounger.
Well, kind of a long story.
I see. Regarding this vision thing, I think that your mind simply played a trick on you there.
We went into a different room.
Not as much of a surprise, considering what you've been through. Actually, you were quite lucky that the sudden outburst of your glance didn't blow your head right off.
Wow. Sudden outburst of my glance? What's a glance other than the traditional definition?
By all that's holy, I won't start playing your tutor now.
But you must.
If you don't know about the basic functioning of magic, then read something from Balador Goldenstein.
Have.
The glance on the Sea of Eventualities. Alongside, but apart from the reality we're in right now, exist countless other realities, in which some events have different outcomes, so to speak.
Right.
A version of this very same room, for example, with the very same people in it, only that Meister Firespark's beard is on fire. And what defines an Arcanist, someone capable of magic, is that he or she can see those other realities and let parts of them come true.
Yeah, set his beard on fire.
Well, look at that, Jasper. You surprise me.
That's what I'm being paid for.
How powerful an Arcanist is depends on three factors. How far away are the eventualities that he can see? How well he can bring parts of them into our reality? And finally, how well his mind can handle seeing other realities simultaneously with ours? Lighting a candle is easier than calling a meteor from the sky, to speak plain Inal. But, as I said, read Goldenstein if you're interested in the topic. I'm not going to waste any time with lectures.
I'm familiar with it. Actually, just recently read the book. It's not going to go up until next month, guys, if you're watching this currently. But yeah, just recently read the book on light magic. The Disciplines of Magic, Light Magic, which I believe is Dal Goldenstein, although I kept saying Goldenstein. The light magic, the healing magic, is actually pretty interesting because you will look into a reality in which the person that you want to heal is not injured, and you'll take the uninjured tendons, flesh, muscle, etc., from that reality and substitute it, you know, with his damaged flesh, etc. Now, the only thing is, you're damaging the version of him in the other reality, though. It's gotta be, like, I immediately thought of that. So, you're basically, yeah. Because energy and matter, they don't disappear. You can make them go places. So we're making damaged tissue go to some other reality and swapping it in place of the other, you know, someone else's healthy, you know, intact tissue. So, say Firespark here was damaged because, you know, someone threw a spell at him or someone decided to fire an arrow at him or something like that, which it hurt his arm. So he's got a lot of damage. He's got a wound on his arm and such. So we're reaching into another reality with a fire spark in that reality and taking the healthy piece of arm and substituting it for his damaged arm. But then just goes to say that the damaged stuff, you're taking it from the other reality, so that fire spark is getting messed up. All of a sudden, his arm is damaged as if it was punctured by an arrow. So, you know, curious to see if they're going to get into that. this chapel on the water, every time I touch one of those stones, I feel as if, I don't know, as if something comes back to me.
Well, that's probably a sign that you should go easier on the booze. Skill, whether of physical or magical nature, isn't gained through touching some stones, but through hard work and discipline. Even though this screwball Endrelayan talk of paths and predeterminations tries to tell us otherwise.
Hmm. Well, again, I did not just imagine these visions. They felt different. Somehow, real.
Oh, well, if that's what you want to believe, go for it.
Oh,
I, in any case, have never come across such a phenomenon in over 50 years of studying magic.
Until now.
And now we should...
It all begins with the dreams.
What the blasted, blistering blazes? Does this room look like the bosom of a whore to you? Or what makes you think you can go around touching anything you get your fingers on? These documents are confidential, for heck's sake. I knew it was a mistake to hire a thug like you. Lashery always had a weakness for...
Correct me if I'm wrong, but I remember you telling me something about dreams that led you and Teal'or Renthiel here, didn't you, Mycer?
Oh, this is the same room.
You told me that in this vision of yours, the Veiled Woman said this.
I just switched
seats.
It
all begins with the dreams.
What? Is that true?
It is, actually.
Oh. Then, this near-death experience you had before you woke up on the shore, tell me again, what exactly did you see in it? A room?
A glistening white light and charred bodies. But their flesh was unnatural, gray, and I heard all these voices.
Hmm. Well, this is strange indeed.
I remember that.
Anyway, for now all that matters is that we get that magic of yours under control. Whatever you clairvoyanced back there is of no use to us if you're dead as a doornail in a couple of months.
I can't argue with that, but, how can we do that? How can we get my magic under control?
Well, that's usually a plodding process. The fever you feel is a result of your mind not being able to handle all of these possibilities, so to speak.
Hmm.
The ritual the Endrelayans practice to get the glance under control is called the Journey to the Water. Put frankly, it means 1 year of hour-long meditation,
what?
Bland food, and abstinence from anything that makes life worth living.
Oh, damn.
In due time, the Arcanist then learns to filter these other realities from ours, and the fever gets less and less. Anyhow, luckily enough, we Neremes know of a way to quicken that process.
Oh, good.
A shortcut, if you will. I'm not capable of performing it, but another one of us is. Her name is Lashery, and you should seek her out as soon as possible.
Hmm. A shortcut. Isn't there a reason that this journey to the water is as lengthy as it is? I mean, would that really work as well?
There is indeed, and this reason is called ignorance. The Order's rituals haven't changed since the Lightborn slipped out of their cradles, and the Keepers do their best to keep anything progressive out of their country.
Hmm.
But please, if you're up for a year of austerity and stern-faced magisters scolding you,
sorry.
Go for it. I really don't care.
Alright, I'll do this ritual of yours. Where can I find this Lashery?
She's currently in a ruin called Old Rationgrad, not far from Ark. Just tell her that I sent you. Give me that map of yours. Okay, now you'd have to be a total idiot to miss it. I recommend leaving for the ruin straight away. And you, Joseph, you're going to come with me and show me what your trip to the Sun Coast brought forth.
You that, Joseph?
Hopefully more than a bottle of honey wine and a hangover.